going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio teams questions about these films. Our categories are books, animals, heroes and villains, and magic. And to run the proceedings, here's our Commissioner of Contraption, Ralph Harris.
Well, thank you, everybody, and thank you, Miranda. Hi, everybody. Our stage is set. We have some great prizes, some wonderful kids who are here to win them, and here come our contraption coaches, Kevin and Robin, with today's team. Our teams were randomly selected before the show, and Robin is the coach of the Red Fireballs. Let's meet them.
Hi, my name is Michelle Dalek, and I'm a terrific cheerleader.
Hi, my name is Ben Spilkes, and I want to be a stuntist.
Hi, my name is Terry Heller, and I want to be a pro motorcycle rider like Bob Hanna and Johnny O'Mara.
Well, let's hear it, Red Fireball. Sounds like a great team. Kevin is the coach of the Blue Darlings, and here they are.
My name is Sarah, and I have a pet desert tortoise.
Hi, my name is Anna, and I like to be a doctor or lawyer when I grow up.
Hi, my name is Andrew Scott, and I got first place in my school speech contest.
Well, let's hear it, Blue Darlings. I think we've got two great teams here today, and kids, we're glad you're with us. Good luck to everybody. Now, we have put three passports in each team's bank. Inside each passport is the name of the first station our kids will be going to today, so kids, get to the dugout. Pick up a passport. Let's all play contraption. Our first station is books, so who's got a passport that says books? Come on over. Well, it looks like Anna for the Blue Darlings and Michelle for the Red Fireballs. Anna, hi. You are in a sign language club. Is that right?
Yeah.
And you do sign language. Would you spell out contraption for us?
C-O-N-T-R-A-P-T-I-O-N.
Well, thank you very much. That was very good. How long have you been signing?
Just for this year.
Well, that was wonderful, and thank you for doing that. Ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck. We'll play in a minute, but let's say hi to Michelle, who wants to be a cheer director. What's the difference between a cheer director and a cheerleader?
Well, the cheer director directs, like, what you're going to be doing, and they lead the cheers and stuff.
Oh, so it's like the head cheerleader?
Yeah.
Okay, well, good luck. You ready to play?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, kids. We're all going to be looking at a scene from a classic movie from the Walt Disney Studios. At the end of the scene, I'm going to be asking you kids questions about it, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to earn one very valuable contraptile for your team. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles wins a bundle of prizes. And we're also going to have a special question just for you at home, so maybe you want to get a pen and paper so you can write down your answer. Famous for years as a play and a book, Peter Pan found a whole new and very appreciative audience when Walt Disney created his exciting film version. Let's find out why. Kids, turn around, and everybody watch the screen.
Oh.
Oh.
What's the chief doing, John?
He's delivering an oration in sign language.
What's he saying?
He says, Peter Pan, mighty warrior, save Tiger Lily, make big chief heap glad.
Well, he certainly doesn't look heap glad.
Make Peter Pan heap big chief. You now, little flying eagle.
Yay! Flying eagle! Hooray!
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 Hooray! Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray!
Teach him, pale-faced brother, all about Red Man.
Good. This should be most enlightening.
What makes the Red Man red?
When did he first say, ugh?
Why does he ask you how?
Why does he ask you how?
Why does he ask you how? What the engine didn't know, all the things that he know now. But the engine, he sure learned a lot. And it's all from asking how. We translate for you. Panda means what panda means, and Gonda means that.
No dance. Oh, get him firewood.
Gunda. When did he first say, oh? When did he first say, oh? In the engine book it say, when first Great Mary saw, he gave out with deep big bow when he saw his mother-in-law.
There's a pretty exciting scene to get us started. Michelle, Anna, turn around. I'll ask the questions. Now, every time you give me a right answer, you're going to hear this sound. That means you earn one contraptile for the team. And remember, at the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is our grand prize winner. So good luck. Here we go, starting with Anna and the blue team. The chief named Peter Pan Big Chief Little Flying Eagle because Peter had saved someone's life. Who did Peter save?
His chief daughter, I guess.
Chief's daughter is correct. Tiger Lily, contraptile for the blue team, and over to Michelle in the red. What object did the chief place on Peter's head? Take a guess.
A ball-like with, I don't know.
It was a headdress, an Indian headdress that he put on Peter's head. Okay, back to the blue team and Anna. What object did everyone pass around and smoke?
Pipe
is correct. The peace pipe, another contraptile for the blue team. Michelle, red. What shape was the smoke ring that Peter and the chief blew?
White?
No, what shape? Not the color, the shape. It was a triangle. Okay, girls, that ends the questions for this round. Now you're going to have a chance to win some more contraptiles for your teams in our exciting jungle boat race. So, Anna and Michelle, if you want to get in those jungle boats, coaches, if you'll help them. And while they're getting ready, here's your special home question. In the scene, Tiger Lily, the Indian princess, was dancing on something. What was it? Later on, I'll tell you the right answer so you can see how well you did. But right now, let's get to that jungle boat race. Kids, one contraptile for the runner-up, two for the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. Take your mark. Get set. Michelle wins it for the red team in a very close race. Come on over, girls. Good race, both of you. Anna, runner-up. Michelle, winner. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team earned?
Well, Anna won 3 contraptiles for the Blue Darlings, and Michelle won 2 contraptiles for the Red Fireball.
Okay, way to go, girls. You both got your teams off to a good start, and now you can head to the dugout, put those contraptiles in your team banks, and that was a good job. Very well done. Our next station is Animals. So who's got a passport that says Animals? Come on over. Excuse me. Looks like Terry for the red team and Sarah for the blue team. Let's see. Terry has won national bike races. What kind of bikes you race, Terry?
GTs.
Are those like on the dirt or on pavement?
On dirt.
And you've also ridden motorcycles. You want to tell us about that?
Yeah, I ride a YZ16. Someday I want to be a pro.
A pro motorcycle rider. Well, good luck. You ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, in a minute, let's first say hi to Sarah, who has danced ballet and been in the opera. Which is your favorite?
I think I like dancing best. I like performing in front of an audience, and dancing I just find most fun.
Is ballet good exercise, too?
Yeah, it is.
All right, you ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, kids, here we go. As athletes, the animals in Bed Knobs and Broomsticks are definitely not ready for the Olympics. So, kids, let's turn around, and everyone, watch closely.
Right, dirty yellows. Let's have a nice clean game. Right, true blues. Best foot forward.
Okay.
You're doing fine, matey. Move it around. Move it around. Get on with the match!
What a game. What a game that is. Okay, kids, turn around. Sarah and Terry, here we go. One contraptile for every correct answer. And remember, you at home can play along with us, see if you can answer the questions, too. We're going to start with Terry and the red team. Terry, which animal wore a crown on his head?
The tiger.
It was the lion. Over to the blue team. And Sarah, which animal bounced the ball with his tail?
The ostrich. The ostrich.
The alligator. It was a good guess, but it was the alligator who bounced the ball. Back to Terry and the red team. Which animal got scared by the mouse?
The elephant.
The elephant is correct. Contraptile for the red team. And Terry, back to Sarah and the blue. What happened to the alligator's tail when the leopard ran over it?
It caught on fire.
Caught on fire is correct. Another a contraptile for the blue team. Good going, both of you. Okay, we're going to go back to the red team and Terry. Which animal lost his shorts when he was kicking the ball?
The ostrich.
It was the leopard. Back to Sarah and the blue team. Which animal buried his head in the sand?
The ostrich, I think.
That time it was the ostrich, correct, and another contraptile for the blue team. And kids, that ends the questions for this round, and you know what that means. Time to win some more in the race. And this time you'll be racing the exciting Wheels of Fire. So coaches, if you'll help the kids get into their wheels, we'll get ready for that race. One contraptile for the runner-up, two contraptiles for the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. One, two, three, and there they go. They're off. Terry ran. He flew in that Wheel of Fire. Sarah, runner-up, winner Terry for the red team. Well, that was one of the fastest races I've seen in a long time. He took off on you, Sarah, but it was a good try anyway. And Miranda, how many contraptiles do we owe these people?
Well, Sarah won three contraptiles for the Blue Darlings, and Terry won three contraptiles for the Red Fireballs.
It's a pretty even round. And kids, you can go to the dugout now. Put those contraptiles in your team banks, and thanks for an exciting round. Very well played. While the kids are heading over to their dugout, I'm going to go over this way and get ready for our next station, which is Heroes and Villains. And I know I've got some people coming over to play with me. It's Andrea for the blue team, Spence for the red. Andrea, you have a dog named Mona Lisa. What about Mona Lisa? How'd he get his name?
Well, we got him when we thought it was a cute name.
And does he answer to just Mona or Lisa? What do you call him just for short?
Mona.
Do any tricks?
No.
Just a good old friend to have around all the time.
He just likes to bite your socks and stuff like that.
Bite? Not my socks.
Mine.
Well, you keep them in good shape, though? I mean, you fix them up and still have them to wear?
Yeah.
All right. You ready to play?
Sure.
Okay, we're going to say hello first to Spence, then we'll get to the game. Spence wants to be a stuntist. What's a stuntist?
It's somebody who jumps off cliffs, crashes cars.
Oh, a stunt performer.
Yeah.
What's your favorite stunt?
All of them.
You like them all. Live dangerously, huh?
Uh-huh.
But not too dangerously. Always be careful.
Yeah.
Okay, ready to play? Mm-hmm. Here we go, kids. Someone has to keep peace in the jungle, especially when there's a murderous tiger on the loose. Let's see how the animals protect themselves in Walt Disney's The Jungle Book. So kids, turn around. Everybody, eyes on the screen.
Patrol.
I give the commands around here? I'll speak up. Who was it?
Oh, it was me, Colonel.
What do you mean, sir? Taking over my command. Highly irregular, you know.
Oh, Colonel, I'm sorry, but I need your help.
Oh, absolutely impossible. We're on a cross-country march.
But it's an emergency, Colonel. The man cub must be found, man.
Cub? What man cub?
How interesting.
The one I was taking to the man village.
Good. That's where he belongs. And now, sir, if you don't mind, we'd like to get on with the march.
No. You don't understand, Hardy. He is lost. He ran away.
How delightful.
Well, it serves a young whippersnapper right.
But Shere Khan, the tiger, he's sure to pick up the man cub's trail.
Shere Khan, nonsense, old boy. Shere Khan is within miles of here.
Okay, kids, turn around. Andrea and Spence. Now, while you were watching that scene, I checked on the score. The blue team is ahead. Could change right here. It's pretty close, but blue team is ahead. Here we go, starting with Andrea and the blue team. What kind of animal was the tiger sneaking up on?
He was sneaking on a deer.
Deer is correct. Contraptile for the blue team. Spence in the red. What kind of animal made the sounds that frightened the tiger away?
Elephant?
Elephants, correct. Contraptile for the red team. Always pays to take a guess. If you don't have anything else, the guess pays off. Andrea in the blue. Which animal caught a ride on his mother's tail?
The little elephant, baby elephant.
Baby elephant is correct. Another contraptile for the blue team. And back to Spence in the red. What object did the leader of the elephants carry in his trunk? Take a guess.
Horn?
No, it was a branch. He was carrying around a little stick in his trunk. Okay, kids, that ends the questions for this round, and you know what that means. It's race time again. Now, this time, we'll be heading for those magic carpets. We're going to go to the magic station in those magic carpets. Should be a good race. And if you'll get ready while they're getting ready, we'll give you the answer to that home question that we asked you earlier. The question was, Tiger Lily, the Indian princess, was dancing on something. What was it? The answer is a drum. We hope you got it right, but right now we're going to get to that magic carpet race. Kids, one contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the bell. On your mark, get set. There they go. Andrea wins it for the blue team. Runner-up Spence for the red. Come on over, kids. It was a good race, but Andrea got in the lead and never looked back. Very good race. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team earned?
Wow, Andrea won 4 contraptiles for the Blue Darlings, and Spence won 2 contraptiles for the Red Fireballs.
Well, good going, both of you. Head to the dugout. Put those contraptiles in your team bank, and thanks again for another exciting round. While the kids are going back, we're going to go this way and get ready for the bonus round. Now, in the bonus round, every correct answer is worth 5 contraptiles, so this is still up in the air. Anybody could win this game. We've got the blue team ahead by a little bit, but that can all change right here because 5 contraptiles is a lot for one question. The station is magic, and we have all the kids from both teams, Anna, Sarah, and Andrea for the blue, Michelle, Spence, and Terry for the red. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Oh, we're all ready now. Okay, kids, good luck, and here we go. The next time your mom tells you to clean up your room, remember this scene from Mary Poppins and do it Mary's way with magic. It's really a snap. So kids, turn around, and everybody enjoy this scene.
me bees that fetch the nectar from the flowers to the comb, never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence, they find, their task is not a
fun scene. Kids, turn around. Now, this could decide it, the bonus round. Remember, in the bonus round, I'll ask a question, then the whole team gets to huddle together, talk it over, and come up with one answer, and I'll ask one of you for the answer that the team decided on. So good luck to everybody, and here we go, starting with the blue team. To make the magic happen, Mary showed the children a simple little trick. What was it? Talking it over now. Andrea's ready.
Snap their fingers together.
Snap their fingers is correct. Five contraptiles for the blue team. Over to the red team. Which of the children learned to make magic first? Talk it over. Okay, we need an answer. Terry, first child to learn was?
The girl.
The girl is correct. Five contraptiles for the red team. A little suspense there. Didn't know if they were going to pull it out. Back to the blue team. What happened when Mary snapped her fingers at the bed? They're ready. Sarah.
It was made.
Correct. The bed was made. Five more contraptiles for the blue team. Back to the red. When Jane snapped her fingers at the blocks, what name did the blocks spell? They're ready. Spence.
Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins is correct. Five more contraptiles for the red team. A perfect bonus round so far. Not a question missed. Going into what could be the last question for each team. Blue team. What toys marched up the blocks and into their toy box? They're ready. Anna.
Soldiers.
Toy soldiers. Absolutely correct. Five more contraptiles for the blue team and back to the red. Which toy jumped from one dresser drawer to another and back again? Talk it over. Need an answer, Michelle.
The ball
is correct. Five contraptiles for the red team. A perfect bonus round. Both teams good going. That ends the questions for the game. And now it's time to find out who today's winner is. The moment we've all been waiting for. So kids, take those contraptiles. Head over towards the contrapta counters. Get to the team banks and let's start piling them on. We're going to see who today's winner is. A perfect bonus round. Keeps things pretty much as it was going in. But we'll find out right now. Red team is up to 3, 4, 5. Well, blue team is already up to 15. Come on, red team, let's get them on there. Blue team is up to 20, passing 20 right now. Red team has 21, 22. The blue team has 25. Blue team wins it. Congratulations. And Miranda, what have we gotten today?
Everyone today has won a colorful Disney lunchbox for mealtime good times. It's an up-to-the-minute Blackwell wristwatch, an LP record album for hours of listening enjoyment. Read aloud classic books featuring favorite Disney stories. A Mickey Mouse tennis racket for all good sports. A pocket-sized AM radio with its own personal headset. And two tickets for an entire day's fun at Disneyland. Today, each lucky member of our winning team will receive a special grand prize. Their very own Texas Instruments home computer for years of fascinating fun and learning. All for you from Contraption.
Congratulations to everybody here. We're glad you all are winners because everybody's a winner on Contraption. We really had a lot of fun today. We hope you had a lot of fun today, too. And we hope to see you right here next time on Contraption. Bye-bye.
On Contraption, we're going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio team questions about these films. Our categories are books, animals, heroes and villains, and magic. And to run the proceedings, here's our Commissioner of Contraption, Ralph Harris.
Well, thank you. Thank you, everybody, and thank you, Miranda High Gang. We are ready to go. We've got some great prizes, some wonderful kids, and here come our clever contraption coaches, Kevin and Robin, with today's team. Our teams were randomly selected before the show, and Robin is the coach of the Red Pirates, and here's the team.
Hi, my name is Jay. I sing anything but punk rock.
Hi, my name is Regina. I collect dolls and trophies, and I have over 100 dolls. A trophy.
Hello, my name's Deanna Brody. I have 2 dogs and 4 birds.
Well, let's hear it, Red Pirates! Looks like a great team. Now, Kevin is the coach of the Blue Ribbons, and here they are.
Hi, my name is Becca, and I did a 97 par in golf.
Hi, my name is Aaron, and I'm in computers and science.
Hi, my name is Samantha. I know how to play Chariots of Fire on the piano.
Well, let's hear it, Blue Ribbons! I think we've got 2 really great teams, and we're glad you're here with us today, kids, and good luck to everybody. Now, we have put 3 passports in each team's bank. Inside each passport is the name of the first station our kids will be going to today. So, kids, head to the dugout, pick up a passport, and let's play Contraption. Our first station is Books. So, who's got a passport that says Books? Come on over. It looks like Becca for the Blue Ribbons and Daniel for the Red Pirates. Becca, you shot a 97 in golf? When did you do that?
Well, last week.
Last week. Could you show me your swing? Could we see Becca's swing? Go ahead. Let me see you stand up to the ball. Okay, just like that.
As you hold on to the golf club and bend your knees a little bit, and then swing your arms back, only bend your right arm, then bring it down. Aim at the ball and hit it.
4. Great shot and a nice swing. Well, good luck with that. And thanks for showing us. Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get to the game in a minute, but first we'll say hello to Daniel, who's got 4 birds. What kind of birds?
I got a cockatoo and 2 leopards and parrot.
Do they talk, any of them?
No.
None of them say a word?
No.
They just make bird chirps, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, ready to play, Dan?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck, everybody. Now, we're all going to be looking at a scene from a classic movie from the Walt Disney Studios. At the end of the scene, I'm going to be asking you kids questions about it, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to earn 1 valuable contraptile. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is going to win a bunch of real nice prizes. And we're also going to have a special question just for you at home, so you might want to get a pencil and paper to write down your answer. Here we go. Based on a story by the Brothers Grimm, Snow White and the 7 Dwarfs was the first full-length animated feature from the Disney Studios. Let's take a look at a scene from this landmark film. So, kids, turn around, and everybody, eyes wide open.
Hello? May I come in?
Oh! But it's sugar!
the look of the table, seven untidy little children. A pickaxe! A stocking, too! And a shoe! And just look at that fireplace. It's covered with dust. And look, cobwebs everywhere. My, my, my. What a pile of dirty dishes. And just look at that broom. Why, they've never swept this room. You'd think their mother would... Maybe they have no mother. Then they're orphans. That's too bad. I know. We'll clean the house and surprise them. Then maybe they'll let me stay.
All right, what a wonderful scene to get us started. Becca and Daniel, turn around, and here we go. I'm going to ask the questions, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to hear this sound, and that means you've earned one of those very valuable, highly coveted, highly acclaimed contraptiles for your team. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is the grand prize winner, so good luck to everybody. Here we go. Becca, blue team. How many little chairs did Snow White see in the cottage?
Seven.
Seven is correct. First contraptile to the blue team. Over to Daniel. Red. When Snow White first arrived, who did she think lived in the cottage? Take a guess, Dan. Children. She thought the children lived there. But we'll go back to the blue team. We'll be back in a minute. What did Snow White find in the cooking pot?
A shoe.
Becca is correct for the blue team. Another contraptile. Okay, Daniel. Red team. When Snow White blew the dust off the fireplace, what did the chipmunk and the squirrels do?
They sneezed and a little squirrel fell in a pot.
That's correct. They sneezed was all we needed. Contraptile for the red team. Kids, that ends the questions for this round. You both got your teams off to a flying start. Now you're going to have a chance to pick up some more contraptiles in our exciting jungle boat race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids into their jungle boats, we'll get ready for that race. And while they're getting ready, here's that special question we promised just for you at home. In the scene, what kind of tool did Snow White find stuck in the table? Later on in the show, we'll give you the right answer so you can see how well you did. But right now, let's get to that jungle boat race. One contraptile for the runner-up and two to the winner. Take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark. Get set. Oh, they're off to a quick start. Looks like it is. Daniel wins it for the red team. Runner-up, Becca for the blue in a good race. I think Becca's foot slipped off the pedal once, and Daniel took advantage of it. But a good race, both of you. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team earned?
Well, Becca won three contraptiles for the blue ribbons, and Daniel won three contraptiles for the red pirate.
Well, that's a pretty even round. And, kids, you can go to the dugout now, put those contraptiles in your team bank, and thanks for an exciting start to this game. Very well done. Our next station is animals, so who's got a passport that says animals? Come on over. Why, it looks like Jay for the red team and Aaron for the blue team. Come on over here, Jay. Jay, you sing opera, or you sing anything but punk rock, but opera and everything else?
Yeah.
Would you sing a little opera for us? You want to clear your throat or something? Go get him.
Lord, don't I marble, Lord, I surrender.
Very nice. Very nicely done. Are you going to stay with us and pursue it?
Yeah.
Well, good luck, and good luck in the game. We'll get over to it in a minute, but first let's say hi to Aaron. And Aaron, you're interested in science and computers. You've done any science projects for school?
Well, yeah, I've done some.
What was your last science project?
Well,
anything exciting?
Well, some of them are.
Okay, well, you're going to stay with science?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready for the game?
Yeah.
Here we go. Here we go, Jay. Aaron? O'Malley the alley cat wants to help his new friends get home, and he's got some unusual ideas about how to get them there in this scene from the Aristocats. So, kids, turn around, and everybody watch closely.
Now, that's quite a family. Come think of it, O'Malley. You're not a cat. You're a rat. Right? Right. Hey, hold up there.
Yes, Monsieur O'Malley?
Now, look, kids. If I said magic carpet it's going to be. And it's going to stop for passengers right here.
Oh, boy, we're going to fly after all.
Another flight into the fantasy, Monsieur O'Malley?
No, baby. Now, you just hide over there and you leave the rest to J. Thomas O'Malley.
Quick, Ma. Get in here.
But, children.
Hurry up, Mama. Hurry.
One magic carpet coming up.
That's a magic carpet?
Sapristi! Stupid cat! Brainless lunatic!
All right, step lively. All aboard for Paris.
Why, Mr. O'Malley, you could have lost your life.
So I got up to you to spare nothing.
How can we ever thank you?
My pleasure. Entirely. Aloha. Auf Wiedersehen. Bonsoir. Sayonara. And all those goodbye things, baby.
Sayonara, Miss Mama! Molly! Hurry!
Marie, are you all right?
Yes, Mama.
Haven't we met before?
And I'm so very glad we did.
Thank you, Mr. O'Malley, for saving my life.
No trouble at all, little princess. And when we get to Paris, I'll show you the time of your life.
Okay, kids, turn around. Aaron and Jay, here we go. Remember, one contraptile for every correct answer. And again, I'm always going to invite you people to play along with us and see if you can answer the question, too. It's kind of contraption fun. Here we go, starting with Jay and the red team. O'Malley said he wasn't a cat. He was another kind of animal. What did he call himself?
A rat.
A rat is correct. Contraptile of the red team over to Aaron and Lou. Aaron, where did O'Malley hide when the truck was coming?
Up in a tree.
Up in a tree is correct. A contraptile for the blue team. Back to Jay and the red. How did O'Malley get the driver to stop the truck?
By screeching and... screaming in front of the window.
Okay, screaming in front of the window. He scared him is correct. Another contraptile for the red team. Aaron, blue team. What did the driver do to start the truck again?
He, cranked up.
That's right. He cranked it up. That's all we needed. Another contraptile for the blue team. Good going. Exciting round here. No misses yet. Jay, red team. When the cats were saying goodbye to O'Malley, one of them fell off the truck. Which one was it?
The girl cat. The girl kitten.
Okay, the little girl kitten is right. Another contraptile and a perfect round for the red team. Okay, Aaron, blue. What city were the cats headed for?
Paris.
Jumped right in with Paris and a correct answer. Another contraptile for the blue team and a perfect round. That ends the questions, kids, for this round. And you know what that means. It's race time, a chance to win some more contraptiles in the exciting Wheels of Fire race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids into the wheels, we'll get ready for the race. One contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. Take your mark. Get set. They're on their way. This race is taking off. We've got a winner already. I think it's Jay for the red team. A good race, a very fast race. Come on over here, Jay. Congratulations. Aaron, runner-up, a good race also. Runner-up for the blue team. And Miranda, how many contraptiles have these guys hit us up for?
Well, Aaron won 4 contraptiles for the blue ribbons, and Jay won 5 contraptiles for the red pirates.
Well, good going, both of you guys. Now head to the dugout, bank those contraptiles. That was a great round. Very well played. While the guys are going back to bank their contraptiles, I'm going to head this way to our next station, which is Heroes and Villains. And I know that I'm going to have some players over here to see me in a... Oh, look at a movie and answer some questions. Samantha for the blue team. Regina for the red team. Hi. Let's see. Samantha. Oh, Samantha, you want me to ask you about your little poodles. How big are they?
Well, I have two dogs, and one's Max and one's Brandy. Max is about this big, and Brandy's about this big.
So one is any, either of them a teacup poodle, a little tiny one?
Well, Max is a small teacup poodle.
Just a little guy. Is he rooting for you today?
Yes.
Okay, well, good luck. We'll play in a minute, but first let's say hi to Regina, who collects all kinds of dolls. How many dolls do you have?
10.
10 dolls. And which is your favorite?
The ones from Spain.
From Spain?
Yes.
Okay, well, good luck. You ready to play?
Yes.
All right, girls, here we go. It's not easy to hide 99 puppies when a murderous villain and her dog-napping henchmen are on your trail. Will Pongo and Perdita save the pups? Let's find out as we watch this scene from 101 Dalmatians. So kids, turn around, and everybody eyes on the screen. That scene, I snuck a peek in the team banks, and it seems that the red team is a little bit ahead, but that could change right now, so good luck. Here we go, starting with Samantha and the blue team. In what type of vehicle were the dogs riding?
A big truck.
A truck is correct. Any size truck would have done it. Contraptile for the blue team. Regina, red. Some of the puppies were hiding in something the van was carrying. Where were they hiding?
The drawers.
Drawers is correct. Contraptile for the red team. Samantha, blue. What were the bad guys, Horace and Jasper, trying to do to the van?
They were trying to, like, go away from that crazy driver that was behind them.
Right. What did they try to make the van do?
They tried to make it go straight, but it kept going to side to side because... she was behind them, and they got all mixed up, and they went to side to side.
So they made it go side to side, tried to
make it turn and go side to side.
Okay, it was, they tried to push it off the road, tried to shove it into the ditch, but a good try, and a long try. We'll be back in a minute. Over to Regina and the red team. One of the puppies fell out of the van. How did the mother dog, Perdita, catch the puppy?
By his tail.
Correct. By the tail. Contraptile red team. Back to Samantha, blue. Jasper was driving the truck. What object came off in his hand?
The wheel of the truck.
The wheel of the truck is absolutely right. Contraptile for the blue team. Back to Regina, red. The van forced Cruella off the bridge. Where did her car end up?
In the snow.
In a snowbank is correct. Another contraptile for the red team and kids. That ends this round. That was well played. And now it's a chance to add your winnings in our exciting magic carpet race. So coaches, if you'll help the kids get into their magic carpets, we'll get ready for the race. And while they're getting ready, here's the answer to that special home question that we asked you earlier. The question was, what kind of tool did Snow White find stuck in the table? The answer is a pickaxe. We hope you got the right answer, but right now let's get to that race. Kids, one contraptile to the runner-up and two to the winner. Take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark, get set. There they go. Another close race, another close race, but Regina wins it for the red team. Come on over, girls. Very good race, both of you. Runner-up was Samantha for the blue, winner Regina for the red, and Miranda, how many contraptiles did these ladies earn?
Well, Samantha won 3 contraptiles for the blue ribbons, and Regina won 5 contraptiles for the red pirates.
Well, good going, both of you. Head to the dugout, put those contraptiles in the team bank, and thanks for a great round. Well played. I'm going this way and get ready for the bonus round. Now, in the bonus round, every correct answer is worth 5 contraptiles, so this is still anybody's game. The red team is a little bit ahead. That can always change at the bonus round because 5 contraptiles is a lot for each question. The station is magic, and we've got all the kids from both teams. It's Aaron, Samantha, and Becca for the blue, and Jay, Regina, and Daniel for the red. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to decide it right here. Magic station, and good luck to everybody. When Mrs. Price's newest magic spell gets out of hand, things really come alive in this scene from Walt Disney's Bedknobs and Broomsticks. So kids, turn around, and everybody watch closely.
What is going on here?
I haven't the foggiest.
That's my nightgown.
Is it really, my dear?
Yes, and I'm not responsible for its behavior.
Obviously not, my dear.
What on earth are you doing?
I'm the jelly guitar, that's what.
How can we stop all this?
Must we? It's really most agreeable.
Yes, but we must do something.
Didn't I give you my all-purpose cut-off spell? This is number 8.
Number 8.
It is number 8, I think it was.
Find me Sandy trousers!
Girls or boat chap, find your own dancing partner. Oh.
Lady, I very much fear that we have nothing under control. Oh, ah! Oh, look, ah! Oh, fear!
Funny scene to end today's game on, but here we go. Good luck to everybody. Now, remember, in the bonus round, I'll ask a question. The whole team gets to talk it over and decide on one answer, and I'll ask one of you for the answer. Starting with the blue team, here we go. What object knocked at the door? Talk it over. Becca.
The sword.
The sword is absolutely right. 5 contraptiles for the blue team and a good start in the bonus round. Red team, here we go. The man was dancing with an article of clothing that belonged to Mrs. Price. What was it? They're talking it over. They're ready. Okay, Daniel.
A nightgown.
Nightgown is correct. 5 contrap piles for the red team. Back to the blue. What was the number of the spell that would make the magic stop? Talk it over. Okay, we need an answer. Samantha.
6? I don't know.
Good to take a guess. The answer was 8, but taking a guess is the right thing to do. Going to the red team now. What object tapped the man on the shoulder, then punched him in the chin? Talk it over. Regina.
The gloves.
Glove is correct. 5 more contraptiles for the red team. Back to the blue. The minister's hat flew off of his head. Where did the hat go? Talk it over. They're talking it over now. I think we need an answer. Aaron.
Inside the house.
In the house is correct. 5 more contraptiles for the blue team. Back to the red for the last question of the day. What animal was sitting and watching the magic happen? Are we ready, Jay?
The cat.
Cat is correct. 5 more contraptiles for the red team. And kids, that ends the bonus round. Now the moment we've all been waiting for. Kids, let's head over to those team banks. Put those contraptiles in there. We'll start piling them on the contrapta counters. Who's today's winner? We're going to find out real soon. Red team is off to a quick start. They've got so many contraptiles, they're dropping them on the floor. Blue is up to 6, 7, still climbing. Red is already up to 12. Well, they've got them all out of the bank, but they've got them hanging on the side of the trap, the counter, 20. Come on, blue team. Blue team is up to 20 also. And the red team has it, 28-20. A great game. Congratulations, red team. And Miranda, what have we got in today's prize package?
Today, all our players win lunchtime fun with a bright and pretty lunchbox, a black hole wristwatch, timely and stylish, a Mickey Mouse wrist and headband set for good times and good sports, a Mickey Mouse Pro-style tennis racket set, favorite Disney stories with read-aloud classic books, an AM radio with bell clip and headset for traveling music, and 2 tickets for a whole day's fun at Disneyland. Today, each lucky member of our winning team will receive a special grand prize, their very own Texas Instruments home computer for years of fascinating fun and learning, all for you from Contraption.
Okay, congratulations to everybody here. It was a great game. Thank you all for watching. We had a lot of fun today. We hope you did too, and we hope we'll see you here next time on Contraption. Bye-bye.
Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our students questions about these films. Our categories are books, animals, heroes and villains, and magic. And to run the proceedings, here's our Commissioner of Contraption, Ralph Harris.
Well, thank you. Thank you, everybody, and thank you, Miranda. Hi, gang. We are ready to go. We've got some great prizes, some wonderful kids, and here come our clever contraption coaches, Kevin and with today's team. Our teams were randomly selected before the show, and Robin is the coach of the Red Pirates, and here's the team.
Hi, my name is Jay. I sing anything but punk rock.
Hi, my name is Regina. I collect dolls and trophies, and I have over 100 dolls. A trophy.
Hello, my name's Deanna Brody. I have 2 dolls and 4 birds.
Well, let's hear it, Red Pirates! Looks like a great team. Now, Kevin is the coach of the Blue Ribbons, and here they are.
Hi, my name is Becca, and I did a 97 par in golf.
Hi, my name is Aaron, and I'm in computers and science.
Hi, my name is Samantha. I know how to play Chariots of Fire on the piano.
Well, let's hear it, Blue Ribbons. I think we've got two really great teams, and we're glad you're here with us today, kids, and good luck to everybody. Now, we have put three passports in each team's bank. Inside each passport is the name of the first station our kids will be going to today. So, kids, head to the dugout, pick up a passport, and let's play contraption. Our first station is books. So, who's got a passport that says books? Come on over. It looks like Becca for the Blue Ribbons and Daniel for the Red Pirates. Becca, you shot a 97 in golf? When did you do that?
Well, last week.
Last week. Could you show me your swing? Could we see Becca's swing? Go ahead. Don't let me see you. Stand up to the ball. Okay, just like that.
Did you hold on to the golf club and bend your knees a little bit and then swing your arms back. Only bend your right arm, then bring it down, aim at the ball, and hit it.
Four. Great shot and a nice swing. Well, good luck with that. And thanks for showing us. Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get to the game in a minute, but first we'll say hello to Daniel. He's got four birds. What kind of birds?
I've got a cockatoo and two lovebirds and parrots.
Do they talk, any of them?
No.
None of them say a word?
No.
They just make bird chirps, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, ready to play, Dan?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck, everybody. Now we're all going to be looking at a scene from a classic movie from the Walt Disney Studios. At the end of the scene, I'm going to be asking you kids questions about it, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to earn one valuable contraptile. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is going to win a bunch of real nice prizes. And we're also going to have a special question just for you at home, so you might want to get a pencil and paper to write down your answer. Here we go. Based on a story by the Brothers Grimm, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs was the first full-length animated feature from the Disney Studios. Let's take a look at a scene from this landmark film. So kids, turn around, and everybody, eyes wide open.
Hello? May I come in?
And Daniel, turn around, and here we go. I'm going to ask the questions, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to hear this sound, and that means you've earned one of those very valuable, highly coveted, highly acclaimed contraptiles for your team. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is the grand prize winner, so good luck to everybody. Here we go. Becca, blue team. How many little chairs did Snow White see in the cottage?
Seven.
Seven is correct. First contraptile to the blue team. Over to Daniel, red. When Snow White first arrived, who did she think lived in the cottage? Take a guess, Dan. Children. She thought the children lived there. But we'll go back to the blue team. We'll be back in a minute. What did Snow White find in the cooking pot?
A shoe.
Becca is correct for the blue team. Another contraptile. Okay, Daniel. Red team.
When Snow White blew the dust off the fireplace, what did the chipmunk and the squirrels do?
They sneezed, and a little squirrel fell in a pot.
That's correct. They sneezed was all we needed. Contrap pile for the red team. Kids, that ends the questions for this round. You both got your teams off to a flying start. Now you're going to have a chance to pick up some more contrap tiles in our exciting jungle boat race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids into their jungle boats, we'll get ready for that race. And while they're getting ready, here's that special question we promised just for you at home. In the scene, what kind of tool did Snow White find stuck in the table? Later on in the show, we'll give you the right answer so you can see how well you did. But right now, let's get to that jungle boat race. One contrap tile for the runner-up and two to the winner. Take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark. Get set. Oh, they're off to a quick start. It is. Daniel wins it for the red team. Runner-up Becca for the blue in a good race. I think Becca's foot slipped off the pedal once, and Daniel took advantage of it. But a good race, both of you. Miranda, how many contrap tiles has each team earned?
Well, Becca won 3 contrap tiles for the blue ribbons, and Daniel won 3 contrap tiles for the red pirates.
Well, that's a pretty even round. And kids, you can go to the dugout now, put those contrap tiles in your team bank, and thanks for an exciting start to this game. Very well done. Our next station is Animals. So who's got a passport that says Animals? Come on over. Why, it looks like Jay for the red team and Aaron for the blue team. Come on over here, Jay. Jay, you sing opera, or you sing anything but punk rock, but opera and everything else?
Yeah.
Would you sing a little opera for us? Do you want to clear your throat or something? Go get him.
Lord, don't know I'm mobile. Lord,
very nice. Very nicely done. Are you going to stay with us and pursue it?
Yeah.
Well, good luck, and good luck in the game. We'll get over to it in a minute, but first let's say hi to Aaron. And Aaron, you're interested in science and computers. You've done any science projects for school?
Well, yeah, I've done some.
What was your last science project?
Well,
anything exciting?
Well, some of them are.
Okay, well, you're going to stay with science?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready for the game?
Yeah.
Here we go. Here we go, Jay. Aaron? O'Malley the alley cat wants to help his new friends get home, and he's got some unusual ideas about how to get them there in this scene from the Aristocats. So, kids, turn around, and everybody, watch closely.
Now, that's quite a family. Come think of it, O'Malley. You're not a cat. You're a rat. Right? Right. Hey, hold up there.
Yes, Monsieur O'Malley?
Now, look, kids. If I said magic carpet it's going to be. And it's going to stop for passengers right here.
Oh, boy, we're going to fly after all.
Another flight into the fantasy, Monsieur O'Malley?
No, baby. You just hide over there, and you leave the rest to J. Thomas O'Malley.
Quick, Mom. Get in here.
But, children.
Hurry up, Mama. Hurry.
One magic carpet coming up.
That's a magic carpet?
Brainless lunatic?
All right, step lively, all aboard for Paris.
Why, Mr. O'Malley, you could have lost your life.
Till I get a few to spare, nothing.
How can we ever thank you?
My pleasure, entirely. Aloha. Auf Wiedersehen. Bonsoir. Saranora. And all those goodbyes there.
Sayonara, Miss Mama! Molly, hurry!
Oh. Marie, are you all right?
Yes, Mama.
Haven't we met before?
Oh, and I'm so very glad we did.
Thank you, Mr. O'Malley, for saving my life.
No trouble at all, little princess. And when we get to Paris, I'll show you the time of your life.
Okay, kids, turn around. Aaron and Jay, here we go. Remember, one contraptile for every correct answer. And again, I'm always going to invite you people to play along with us and see if you can answer the question, too. It's kind of contraption fun. Here we go, starting with Jay and the red team. O'Malley said he wasn't a cat. He was another kind of animal. What did he call himself?
A rat.
A rat is correct. Contraptile for the red team over to Aaron and Lou. Aaron, where did O'Malley hide when the truck was coming?
Up in a tree.
Up in a tree is correct. The contraptile for the blue team. Back to Jay and the red. How did O'Malley get the driver to stop the truck?
By screeching and screaming in front of the window.
Okay, screaming in front of the window. He scared him is correct. Another contraptile for the red team. Aaron, blue team. What did the driver do to start the truck again?
He cranked up.
That's right. He cranked it up. That's all we needed. Another contraptile for the blue team. Good going. Exciting round here. No misses yet. Jay, red team. When the cats were saying goodbye to O'Malley, one of them fell off the truck. Which one was it?
The girl cat. The girl kitten.
Okay, the little girl kitten is right. Another contraptile and a perfect round for the red team. Okay, Aaron, blue. What city were the cats headed for?
Paris.
Jumped right in with Paris and a correct answer. Another contraptile for the blue team in a perfect round. That ends the questions, kids, for this round. And you know what that means. It's race time, a chance to win some more contraptiles in the exciting Wheels of Fire race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids into the wheels, we'll get ready for the race. One contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. Take your mark. Get set. They're on their way. And this race is taking off. We've got a winner already. I think it's Jay for the red team. A good race, a very fast race. Come on over here, Jay. Congratulations. Aaron, runner-up, a good race also. Runner-up for the blue team. And Miranda, how many contraptiles have these guys hit us up for?
Well, Aaron won four contraptiles for the Blue Ribbons, and Jay won five contraptiles for the Red Pirates.
Well, good going, both of you guys. Now head to the dugout, bank those contraptiles. That was a great round. Very well played. While the guys are going back to bank their contraptiles, I'm going to head this way to our next station, which is Heroes and Villains. And I know that I'm going to have some players over here to see me in a... Oh, look at a movie and answer some questions. Samantha for the blue team. Regina for the red team. Hi. Let's see. Samantha. Oh, Samantha, you want me to ask you about your little poodles. How big are they?
Well, I have two dogs, and one's Max and one's Brandy. Max is about this big, and Brandy's about this big.
So one is any, either of them a teacup poodle, a little tiny one?
Well, Max is a small teacup poodle.
Just a little guy. Is he rooting for you today?
Yes.
Okay, well, good luck. We'll play in a minute. But first, let's say hi to Regina, who collects all kinds of dolls. How many dolls do you have?
10.
10 dolls. And which is your favorite?
The ones from Spain.
From Spain?
Yes.
Okay, well, good luck. You ready to play?
Yes.
All right, girls, here we go. It's not easy to hide 99 puppies when a murderous villain and her dog-napping henchmen are on your trail. Will Pongo and Perdita save the pups? Let's find out as we watch this scene from 101 Dalmatians. So kids, turn around, and everybody eyes on the screen.
Driver.
bit of a nudge and shove him in the ditch.
Watching that scene, I snuck a peek in the team banks, and it seems that the red team is a little bit ahead, but that could change right now, so good luck. Here we go, starting with Samantha and the blue team. In what type of vehicle were the dogs riding?
A big truck.
A truck is correct. Any size truck would have done it. Contraptile for the blue team. Regina, red. Some of the puppies were hiding in something the van was carrying. Where were they hiding?
The drawers.
Drawers is correct. Contraptile for the red team. Samantha, blue. What were the bad guys, Horace and Jasper, trying to do to the van?
They were trying to, go away from that crazy driver that was behind them.
Right. What'd they try to make the van do?
They tried to make it go straight, but it kept going to side to side because she was behind them, and they got all mixed up, and they went to side to side.
So they made it go side to side, tried to
make it turn and go side to side.
Okay, they tried to push it off the road, tried to shove it into the ditch, but a good try, and a long try. We'll be back in a minute. Over to Regina and the red team. One of the puppies fell out of the van. How did the mother dog, Perdita, catch the puppy?
By his tail.
Correct. By the tail. Contraptile red team. Back to Samantha blue. Jasper was driving the truck. What object came off in his hand?
The wheel of the truck.
The wheel of the truck is absolutely right. Contraptile for the blue team. Back to Regina. Red. The van forced Cruella off the bridge. Where did her car end up?
In the snow.
In a snowbank is correct. Another contraptile for the red team. And kids, that ends this round. It was well played. And now it's a chance to add your winnings in our exciting magic carpet race. So, coaches, if you'll help the kids get into their magic carpets, we'll get ready for the race. And while they're getting ready, here's the answer to that special home question that we asked you earlier. The question was, what kind of tool did Snow White find stuck in the table? The answer is a pickaxe. We hope you got the right answer, but right now let's get to that race. Kids, one contraptile to the runner-up and two to the winner. Take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark, get set. There they go. Another close race. Another close race, but Regina wins it for the red team. Come on over, girls. Very good race, both of you. Runner-up was Samantha for the blue, winner Regina for the red, and Miranda, how many contraptiles did these ladies earn?
Well, Samantha won 3 contraptiles for the blue ribbons, and Regina won 5 contraptiles for the red pirates.
Well, good going, both of you. Head to the dugout, put those contraptiles in the team bank, and thanks for a great round. Well played. I'm going this way and get ready for the bonus round. Now, in the bonus round, every correct answer is worth 5 contraptiles, so this is still anybody's game. The red team is a little bit ahead. That can always change at the bonus round because 5 contraptiles is a lot for each question. The station is magic, and we've got all the kids from both teams. It's Aaron, Samantha, and Becca for the blue, and Jay, Regina, and Daniel for the red. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to decide it right here. Magic station, and good luck to everybody. When Mrs. Price's newest magic spell gets out of hand, things really come alive in this scene from Walt Disney's Bedknobs and Broomsticks. So kids, turn around, and everybody watch closely.
Yay!
is going on here?
Why, I'm the foggiest.
That's my nightgown.
Is it really, my dear?
Yes, and I'm not responsible for its behavior.
Obviously not, my dear. What?
Oh, what on earth are you doing?
I'm the jelly guitar, that's what.
How can we stop all this?
Must we? It's really most agreeable.
Yes, but we must do something.
Didn't I give you my all-purpose cut-off spell? This is number eight.
Number eight.
It is number eight, I think it was.
Oh, my Sunday trousers!
Girls, old Mojo, find your own dancing partner. Oh.
Your shoes.
Lady, I very much fear that we have nothing under control. Oh, ah! Oh, look, ah! Oh, fear!
Funny seed to end today's game on, but here we go. Good luck to everybody. Now, remember, in the bonus round, I'll ask a question. The whole team gets to talk it over and decide on one answer, and I'll ask one of you for the answer. Starting with the blue team, here we go. What object knocked at the door? Talk it over. Becca.
The sword.
The sword is absolutely right. Five contraptiles for the blue team and a good start in the bonus round. Red team, here we go. The man was dancing with an article of clothing that belonged to Mrs. Price. What was it? They're talking it over. They're ready. Okay, Daniel.
The nightgown.
Nightgown is correct. Five contraptiles for the red team. Back to the blue. What was the number of the spell that would make the magic stop? Talk it over. Okay, we need an answer. Samantha.
Six? I don't know.
Good to take a guess. The answer was eight, but taking a guess is the right thing to do. Going to the red team now. What object tapped the man on the shoulder, then punched him in the chin? Talk it over. Regina.
The gloves.
Glove is correct. Five more contraptiles for the red team. Back to the blue. The minister's hat flew off of his head. Where did the hat go? Talking it over now. I think we need an answer. Aaron.
Inside the house.
In the house is correct. Five more contraptiles for the blue team. Back to the red for the last question of the day. What animal was sitting and watching the magic happen? Are we ready, Jay?
The cat.
Cat is correct. Five more contraptiles for the red team. And kids, that ends the bonus round. Now the moment we've all been waiting for. Kids, let's head over to those team banks. Put those contraptiles in there. We'll start piling them on the contrapta counters. Who's today's winner? We're going to find out real soon. Red team is off to a quick start. They've got so many contraptiles, they're dropping them on the floor. Blue is up to six, seven, still climbing. Red is already up to 12. Well, they've got them all out of the bank, but they've got them hanging on the side of the trap, the counter, 20. Come on, blue team. Blue team is up to 20 also. And the red team has it, 28-20. A great game. Congratulations, red team. And Miranda, what have we got in today's prize package?
Today, all our players win lunchtime fun with a bright and pretty lunchbox, a black hole wristwatch, timely and stylish, a Mickey Mouse wrist and headband set for good times and good sports, a Mickey Mouse Pro-style tennis racket set, favorite Disney stories with read-aloud classic books, an AM radio with bell clip and headset for traveling music, and two tickets for a whole day's fun at Disneyland. Today, each lucky member of our winning team will receive a special grand prize, their very own Texas Instruments home computer for years of fascinating fun and learning. All for you from Contraption.
Okay, congratulations.
was a great game. Thank you all for watching. We had a lot of fun today. We hope you did too, and we hope we'll see you here next time on Contrep. Bye-bye. Thank you.